Jermall Charlo is one of Ryan Garcia's biggest supporters out of any other pro boxer. And today, fight week, he's hanging out with Ryan. And you'll see in a second a video where Ryan tells him, if you lose, I'll cover the bet. If you win, you win. So Jermall Charlo, Ryan Garcia. Jermall's putting 10 to 20,000 on Ryan. Check it out.
Lies on!
If you lose, I'll give you the
money.
Okay.
I agree.
Ryan. If you win, I'll take
your winnings.
I agree. Ryan, I'm putting you in the red one.
So first of all, Oscar, we're 48 hours to fight night. It's so exciting. First of all, congratulations on the Ring Magazine belt.
Yeah.
How does it feel?
Wait, why do you point at her shoes or boots?
No, because I thought she held the belt a second ago. But
I'm just kidding, brother.
I know.
Okay.
How does it feel to get your belt after all these years?
I was hoping you would wear it tonight.
I told Razo from Golden Boy, if it stays with us tonight, it's either getting lost or something. I'll take it back to LA.
Congratulations.
Thank you, brother.
Must feel special.
You know, it feels great, man. It feels... The ring belt is the most prestigious belt in the world. And for many reasons, you know, obviously the best have to fight the best, which is very important, but there's no political agenda behind it. Zero whatsoever.
No fees.
There's no sanctioning fees. So don't you think, first of all, a fighter would want a beautiful belt like the Ring Magazine belt, but more importantly, they would want the belt because they have to earn it. They have to fight the best against the best, the number one, the number two, or the number one, sometimes number three, because the number two wasn't available. You have to win, you have to lose that belt inside the ring. And it doesn't get any better than that. If you don't have a ring championship belt in your lifetime, then think about maybe you did something wrong. Maybe you didn't play your cards right. Maybe you didn't want to fight the very best. You have to ask yourself, you know. So the ring belt, I'm very proud of it. I'm very proud of it because it's one of those organizations that have integrity.
I have to ask you about the fight. So how tense did it get up there on stage today? You gave a little speech. It jump started the whole press conference. It lit up the room.
Lit up everything. And look, I'm just speaking the truth. I'm speaking from the heart. I'm speaking from experience. I've been there. I've done that. I've been on that stage 40 some odd times in major events. So you know, I know exactly what's going on. I know exactly what they're feeling. I know exactly, you know, the tension and you know, the questions that the fighters are asking. You know, it's part of the game, but it's going to come down to who has the most discipline, who has the best team in their corner, and the fighter just has to go out and execute.
To end this interview really quick, Tank and Ryan talked about the bet winner takes all. Never happened. Would you ever take such a bet?
No, I wouldn't. I wouldn't bet. I could have fought anybody, but I know that I can beat him, and I still wouldn't bet. You know, I'm putting my life on the line inside the ring, which is obviously much bigger than a big bet. Yeah.
Thank you so much. There's a lot of people waiting. Thanks, Oscar. I wanted to ask him about a bet. I'll put $100. Who hits more out of 10? You or Oscar? Golf.
What do you mean? Who hits more? Like, who hits it better?
Oh, really?
He's lefty. I'm right.
But
let's go try it.
All right, we'll try it.
Yeah.
All right, stay tuned. Don't miss it.
Yeah, don't miss that.
Ellie Sekback, reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com.
I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.